If you work and play in an urban environment, you might be intrigued by the prospects of owning an electric car. And you'd be surprised to learn that there are a number of them on the market. Well, kind of. Many manufacturers limit sales to a handful of states, but there are some that are more readily available, and almost none cheaper than the Mitsubishi iMiEV.
There are currently about a dozen fully electric cars available to U.S. consumers, if you live in selected geographical areas, ranging in price from under $25,000 for a base iMiEV to well over $100,000 for a high-end Tesla Model S, and all of them qualify for a $7,500 federal income tax credit. By EPA estimates, it costs on average between $500 and $700 per year to juice one, saving owners $5,000 to $6,000 in fuel costs over 5 years. That equates to using about 8 gallons of petroleum annually, whereas your gas-fueled car might use well over 500. And of course, there are zero tailpipe emissions. They come in a variety of body styles, but none as unusual as this. I first drove an iMiEV prototype in 2009, and this is my first go-around since. Mitsu skipped the 2015 model year for the iMiEV and sold less than 200 of them last year. It's back for 2016 in all of its golf cart glory, and if you leave off the $2,000 navigation package, it comes in as the most affordable electric vehicle in America, with an MSRP of $23,845 including destination, beating out the Smart for 2 electric drive coupe by about $2,000. But whereas Hyundai and Kia have demonstrated that a quality car doesn't have to be expensive, Mitsu subscribes to the theory that you get what you pay for. Understandably, not everyone can afford a $30,000 Nissan Leaf, and the fact that Mitsu delivers a 5-door electric car with a 62-mile driving range on the cheap is fundamentally commendable. It's rear drive and uses a 16-kilowatt-hour lithium-ion drive battery that feeds an electric motor that produces 66 horsepower and 145 pound-feet of torque. For some perspective, the Leaf's larger battery produces 107 horsepower, 187 pound-feet of torque, and delivers a driving range of 84 miles. But the iMiEV is smaller, a subcompact, and Mitsu has kept the weight down to an impressive 2,579 pounds, considerably less than even a BMW i3.
The iMiEV has two charge ports, one for plugging into your standard household outlet and at public charging stations, and another for the hard-to-find Level 3 charger, which replenishes the battery in a mere 15 minutes.
If you live off of 120 volts, it takes between 14 and 22 hours to fully charge, and about 6 hours at a 240-volt charging station. All electrified cars I've driven incorporate EV-specific whiz-bang electronics and provide a smartphone app to monitor charge status and the like. You'll find very little of that here. Instead, you get things like this radio transmitter key fob with a pull-out antenna and a Navi system with POIs, including needless gas stations. It's all as if Mitsu spent 99% of their energy developing the propulsion system and 1% on the car surrounding it.
The only factory-installed option you can get is this newly available touchscreen navigation system. And frankly, it's not half bad. But everything else about this interior lets you know exactly how Mitsu keeps the price so low. It is embarrassingly cheap.
From the hollow-sounding doors to the dreadful appearance of the cabin, everything feels like it's one more touch away from breaking. As if you needed any more proof, this solidifies that Mitsu is either clueless or simply doesn't care about the demands of the American market.
Fact of the matter is that the iMiEV drives pretty well. Its 60 to 90 mile range is sufficient for most daily activities, it's electric quick, and the ride is tuned for softness. You sit elevated with this huge windshield out ahead, and as long as you're not on the highway, it's pleasantly quiet.
With the optional USB port and Navi package, this iMiEV ES stickers for $25,980. If low price is your only criteria for EV purchase, then here's your answer. Otherwise, aspire for something more. For TestDriveNow.com, I'm Steve Hannis.